Hello everyone, welcome back to Tector.com. In this lecture we will start normal form, the first normal form. So a relation could be in various normal form. Let's say it is in first normal form, second normal form and third normal form. Okay, all these criteria of normal forms being satisfied by relation R, then we say that this relation R is in third normal form. Okay, the highest criteria and the highest normal forms criteria it satisfies, we say that this relation, particular relation, is in that particular normal form. It is something like a student is, let's say it is 10th pass, then 12th pass and then graduation, UG. Then what will be the qualification of this student? So he will be saying undergraduate, right? Okay, or graduation. He won't say 10th, 12th, graduation. All these things will not be, he will not be saying. So this is very similar to this. Student is 12th pass only if he is 10th pass. Similarly, a student relation will be in second normal form only if it is in first normal form. So the criteria of first normal form has to be satisfied first. Okay. Similarly, the criteria to be in third normal form, the criteria of second normal form has to be satisfied first, right? So likewise, we will apply certain checks on a relation and we will find out what is the highest normal form a relation possesses. Okay, so let's get started with first normal form. Here is some formal criteria which a relation should satisfy to be in first normal form. So the first one is all the values of each attribute is atomic. What does it mean? That in a shell of this table which we see generally, all the values should be atomic. We will just take an example. So let's first go through this, all the criterias. The next is no composite values or attribute. It means, let's say you have your name, such as first name, last name, surname, all these things. So this, your name is an attribute which has sub attributes, right? First name, last name, surname, etc. So these all things cannot be accommodated together in the database. So the value should not be composite. Fine. Now the next criteria is all entities in any column must be of the same kind. What I mean to say is, when you have a column of date of birth, you cannot write your name there. Okay. So the data type should be same. Each column must have a unique name, right? The column names, that is attribute names, must be unique and no two rows are identical. So let's first take two examples of relationship and try to identify which one is satisfying all the criteria and is in first normal form. Here we have a student table, database of student, in which we are storing the name of student and the courses opted by the student. So if you can see, this roll number of this student is 101, name is Asif, and these are the courses he has opted, right? There are other entries also, but if you see here in courses, if there are many courses, okay, the values are not atomic here, okay? They have four subjects and they have entered all the subjects' name into this particular field only, right? So this is not atomic. This is not atomic, not, right? So basically it is not satisfying our criteria for being in first normal form. So this is not in first normal form. Now we will do some modifications. Apart from this, all criteria are satisfied, that is no two rows are identical. So this is a row, that is a record information about a student. So no two information are same. Okay, each columns must have unique names, so column names are unique. Fine, there are no two columns having, let's say, name, two columns are there with the same name. It's not the case here. And all entities in any column must be of the same kind. So this name is on same kind, character type, roll number is roll number, numeric values. Okay, the type is same. So it is satisfying all condition except this first one, which is saying that the values should be atomic. The values are not atomic, so we will do a small modification on this table to make it in first normal form. The only criteria which the first table, that is the student table, was not satisfying is the values being non-atomic. Okay, so what we will do is we will just repeat these values, these entries, with the single values of courses. So here we had DBMS, computer network, CN, CD and software engineering, all these multiple values. Now to make it atomic, we will just repeat these values as DBMS, CN, CD and SE. Okay, and all these values will be repeated. Now if you see, all the values are, all the criterias are satisfied by this modified database. All the records are unique, as you can see that this two fields are same but the course is different. So these two records are different. Fine. Now this column must have unique name, so the columns are already, I mean all the criterias was already satisfied. The only thing was that the value was not atomic, so it is now atomic and it is in first normal form. So whenever you get a question on this, that to find out whether a relation is in first normal form or not, you have to just take care whether the values are atomic in the shell or not. If the values are atomic like in this table, it will be in first normal form. But if there are multiple values like this, they will not be in first normal form. So as simple as that. So I hope this is clear. Thanks for watching.